bring the crystal with you. You will need it to free me from my bonds. I have waited for centuries. And waited and waited. Do you know how boring that can be? But now, you are here. Just as Meridia foretold. The Radiant One knows many things. She knew that one day the city she plunged into Cold Harbor would serve her purpose. At first, she thought I would fulfill that prophecy. But I failed. And now, I need your help. Have no fear. I am as alive as you are. Molag Bal has preserved me so that I can endure his endless tortures. His cruelty knows no bounds. I can't slip free of this lightless oubliette, but I have managed to send my projection to meet you. I knew you were the one I was waiting for. Molag Bal locked me away for a reason. He fears me. Once you set me free, we can make him regret the day he made us his enemies. You made it this far, just as I had predicted. I am glad to see that my calculations were not in error. Now, if you are ready, we have a prison to break out of. I was captured shortly after Meridia pushed her city into this dread realm. This prison relies on darkness. Early on, I almost broke free. Now Molag Bal shapes the darkness itself to bind me, suppressing my attempts to escape. Molag Bal has trapped me within a pillar of darkness, infused with his own vile energy and powered by the light of Meridia. That, however, will be his undoing. The light of Meridia can also banish this darkness. But you have to bring it to me. To reach me, you must first unlock the prison door. Molag Bal uses crystallized darkness to hold me and suppress my power. Move the crystals from their locations to the prison door, and the way shall be opened for you. I am the last alien king. In our ancient language, my name means ruler in dark times. I can imagine no darker time than the end of the alien people. I am a servant of Meridia, her master tactician and strategist. Between my master's blessings and the time-distorting nature of this dread realm, I am still alive. Consider that your good fortune, for you will never defeat Molag Bal without my help. To reach me, you must first unlock the prison door. Molag Bal uses crystallized darkness to hold me and suppress my power. Move the crystals from their locations to the prison door, and the way shall be opened for you. Enter the frozen alcove and collect the flame shadow crystal. Then place it on the central dais at the entrance. Come on. Enter the garden and collect the life shadow crystal. Then place it on the central dais at the entrance. Enter the library and collect the Mind Shadow Crystal. Then place it on the central dais at the entrance. Ugh! Enter this lightless oubliette. Draw upon the light of Meridia to protect you. done, my friend. Now, enter the oubliette and set me free. Done well to make it this far. But there is still more to do to set me free. My body is imprisoned within a pillar of darkness, generated by the ebon shards to each side. Place a light of Meridia in both of the sconces. Each will create a beam of light that will strike a nearby crystal. By rotating the crystals, you can change a beam's direction. You may need to rotate a crystal multiple times to connect the beams and form a path of light to the ebon shards. Adjust the crystals until the beams of light destroy the ebon shards. Then the pillar of darkness will collapse, and I shall be free.
Woo!
long last. My calculation suggested that you had a slightly better chance to fail rather than to succeed. I suspect, though, that you often beat the odds. Thank you. Agreed. Allow me to create a portal to Meridia's city. We can speak there. This portal leads to the Hollow City. We shall talk again when we are safely inside its walls.
Smashing! So glad you could join us. Welcome to the Fighters Guild, which is rather a mundane name, isn't it? Though it is precise. They fight things and they're in a guild. Works rather well, actually, come to think of it. Actually, it was Honor who found them. Have you met? We've been together forever. He knows Cold Harbor almost as well as I do. Pish tosh! Honor isn't a pet. He's my faithful steed. He does mistake the odd wood elf for a tasty treat, but they've been known to do that themselves, haven't they? Oh.
I have barely set foot within these hallowed walls, and I already feel 1,000 times better. And now that you are here, we can determine our next move against the vile Molag Bal. I must take stock of our assets and resources, determine just how much might we can bring to bear. Only then can I develop a strategy that shall allow us to win this war. But forgive me. I wanted to convey that you performed admirably at the tower. It is good to be back in this ancient city. I need to assess our strengths and weaknesses, determine how best to make our assault against Molag Bal. If we strike before we build up a sufficient force, however, I fear we shall lose this war. Soldiers, the ones who call themselves the Fighters Guild. They seem strong and capable, at least at first glance. I shall speak to their leader at once. No leader? Well, that is an unacceptable situation. I shall take command of this Fighter Guild force. It is the only logical solution. Talk to those within this building. After I consult with the groundskeeper, I shall join you inside.
The pieces begin to fall into place. With the King's aid, we shall assemble a force worthy of Meridia's blessing. Small groups have trickled in since your departure. The warriors inside seem to be under the protection of the knight Darian, an exceptional fellow. Brave to a fault and devoted to lost causes. Cadwell found them in the wilds.
Your nagging is becoming more annoying than my persistent rash. We finally have a secure base. To go back outside without a plan is even too foolhardy for me.
You want us to hide behind these walls? To leave our comrades to die while you sip wine and lounge about? You have no honor, knight.
Don't lecture me about honor, elf. You have no idea what I've seen or what I've gone through.
I refuse to leave our guildmates to rot in the wilds of this wicked place. I don't care about the dangers. How would you feel if it were you still out there? Wouldn't you want us to come and find you?
My apologies for that display. The whole rash comment. Just a figure of speech, of course. So, I suppose you know more about this place than any of us. Like where I can get a decent drink? A safe haven, eh? I didn't really expect to see cheerful flowers and clear water anywhere in this dark realm. I assumed we were walking into untimely and painful deaths. Glad to see I was wrong this one time. I couldn't let you go off and save the world all by yourself, could I? Not with just these Fighters Guild braggarts. Besides, there was a portal. How could I not step through and see what was on the other side? That's a good question. I heard that Captain Alfari was killed shortly after we were scattered. I was hoping to find another officer here, but no such luck. An alien? I thought they were all, you know, dead. Of course, this is a Daedric Prince's plane. I really need to stop being surprised by such revelations. I have a feeling that won't be the strangest thing I find out before this is all over.
Attend me, soldiers. We have a war to win, and time grows short.
What in Auriel's name is this? Who are you?
So that's the last alien, huh? I thought he'd be more dusty. Isn't that what happens when elves get really, really old?
Shut it, you fop.
Who's in charge of this group? Step forward and address me. Then allow me to rectify that. I shall lead you. We shall recover your comrades and complete your mission. If that does not work for you, your services are no longer needed.
I don't know who you are, but you aren't Fighters Guild. You have no authority over us.
Do you challenge me, then? Do you want me to kill you to prove my combat prowess to your companions?
I wouldn't necessarily mind seeing that. He is kind of annoying.
How can you expect us to lay down our lives for someone we never met? Trust is earned on the battlefield.
If you want to survive, if you want to win this, you must trust me. Allow me to explain why you need my leadership. We shall work this out. I understand your reservations, but with my leadership, the Fighters Guild will help us win this war.
Well, the King certainly doesn't lack confidence. I can appreciate that. Might put our friend here in his place. That'd be delightful to see. I think there are a lot of good soldiers out there who need our help. I also know that if we just charge out there with no plan, we're as good as dead. I'm always eager to rescue a fair maiden or two, but not at the cost of everyone's life.
I refuse to leave our guildmates to rot in the wilds of this wicked.
I do not expect this group to blindly trust me. That would be foolish. I plan to instill them with confidence so that when the others arrive, they will follow me without question. For now, I shall speak with each soldier here. Tell them what I think we should do and how we should do it. Perhaps listen to their opinions. To rush into battle with no allegiance is to command a unit that is already defeated. Continue to amass our forces until we have enough troops. Then we meet in council and plan our attack. The chasm to the north protects Morlog Baal's inner sanctum. We must cross it and confront the prince if we hope to save Nirn.
The pieces begin to fall.